thank you. It's time to talk about your money now. Has this pandemic caused you to maybe pivot in thinking about retirement? Well, if so, we do have some tips on how to make sure you're ready when the time comes to finally stop working. Stewart Wells from the Wells Group joins us this morning by FaceTime with the information on getting you prepared. Stewart, good to see you this morning.
Good morning, Mike. How are you doing?
We're doing well. We can't complain. All right. So we do know that a lot of people have been hurt with their retirement accounts because of the what's happening to the economy. But let's talk about what should we be doing now to prepare ourselves for retirement.
Well, and Mike, I think this is just a kind of a back to basics moment, particularly for pre-retirees. So this will be people that are be retiring within, say, the next 10 years. And I think the first step is to make sure you know your numbers. And I want to give them a site to go to that they can get help. And this is under ssa.gov, that's Social Security Administration.gov, and you go to My Social Security, set up an account, and first thing you want to do is find out what your Social Security estimates are, and that can get you there. But they also have a really nifty retirement estimator, so you can sit down and do a lot of what-ifs about your retirement. You want to make sure you understand your income numbers, so Social Security and a pension if you have it, how much income you can take out of IRAs and personal investment accounts. That should be limited to around 3 to 5% generally, but you can do what ifs. And you also want to do the same thing on the expense side. Make sure you know your income and your expenses.
Okay. Well, and we know you've said before, it's very important to have an emergency fund. A lot of people don't know, okay, well, how much should that be?
Well, I think COVID, if anything, has made people realize you never know what might happen. A lot of things happen that you can't expect, and emergency reserves is one of those. It becomes very, very important how much it should be. It's usually going to be, Mike, a multiple of your monthly living expenses, and this is very personal. So for some people, it might be as little as 3 months. For a lot of people, it would be as much as 12 months. It depends on how steady that income is. So if you have a big Social Security account, you have a big pension account, that number might not have to be as much. But I tell people, come up with your best number, then double it. And oftentimes they'll find out that that was just about right.
All right, finally, we have a little bit of time left to talk about mastering your money. A lot of that involves the budget. And just get into a couple of specifics, if you could, with the limited like 40 seconds we have, on what people should do when they try to establish that.
Well, I think it's a mindset. But think of it as you're running a small business. You've got income, you've got expenses. You've got to manage both of those for a lifetime, and in many cases, for two lifetimes. I think what's really critical, the takeaway from that is, make sure that both spouses are familiar with the numbers. They both need to be, because it might be the spouse that doesn't know much about the numbers that is the one that lives the longest.
Stewart Wells from the Wells Group, appreciate the information this morning.
Thank you, Mike.